5 years ago, I came to Reno. I like the people, I like fishing especially, and that's why I chose to open up the gym here.
I've been grappling for 12 years, since I was 12. Wrestling, and then I started doing jiu-jitsu 5 years ago.
Okay.
But I started doing jiu-jitsu with Renzo Gracie 4 years ago, back in 2018. Well, first I started doing MMA, I want to say 5 years ago. But I didn't like getting punched in the face that much, so I started doing grappling. The ABCC was a couple weeks ago. It's like the world championship, so it's like, you know, you have to go through the trials and all that. And yeah, there's like 13,000 people at the arena, and it was a pretty cool experience. What happened was I was invited, so I didn't win the trials, but what happened was, so there was two trials. The East Coast, I got second, and the West Coast, I got fourth on the fall because of injury. Because I lost in the semifinals. But yeah, I just got invited. I lost the first round, but the guy who beat me eventually got second. But put in a really good fight against him. And yeah, I didn't do too bad. ADCC is the highest pinnacle of the sport. So not anybody could get into that sport, right, or that event. So yeah, it's just top 16 in the world. Like, just pick. They don't pick anybody. I'm training for Nogi Worlds in December. So Nogi Worlds, it's a different federation. So it's not a ADCC. It's IBJJF. So it's like a different federation. Yeah. And that one's still pretty, like, you know, pretty big. I mean, it taught me a lot of things, like mental toughness, determination, and work ethic and discipline. It's a very... beautiful art in that way.
It is commitment and dedication to the sport. There hasn't been a class that has taught that I've taught that he hasn't showed up to. All right, he's in here three times a day, working hard. He's doing his workouts outside the gym. He's got the mindset of a champion. Just when he goes to compete, he's good at being by himself in solitude, because that's when you step on the mat. You're all alone. The work is behind you. That's my job, being prepared. But he has the mind of a champion. He'll go out there and he competes like he trains. Dedication, hard work. Yeah, there's a lot of moves, counter moves. It's a very complex game. They like it, you know, the ultimate goal of jiu-jitsu is more than just takedowns, right? The crowning jewel of jiu-jitsu is submissions. So there's a lot of pins on the way there, a lot of takedowns on the way to get that submission. Judo, you can take somebody down. That's the ippons, the crown jewel. Wrestling's a pin. But jiu-jitsu incorporates all of that to get to the submission.
If you're not good enough in, like, wrestling, then it's like, what's the purpose of, like, jiu-jitsu? But, I mean, unless somebody pulls guard, but also it's like, I think it also helps with, like, the mindset as well. Because, like, wrestling's more like getting after it, but jiu-jitsu's more of, like you said, like, chess. It's, like, very, like, philosophical and, like, you have to be clever and all that. You think he's going to do one thing, but actually has, like, you know, other motives from there. So you have to, like, think, like, seven steps ahead.
No one comes out and wins everything right out of the gate. But how you deal with your losses say a great thing about how you're going to become a good practitioner. Everyone loses right out of the gate. It's going back to the drawing board. They're good at identifying and laying out a blueprint for me as a coach and a teacher to work on. So, yeah, they're necessary. They're a necessary part of climbing your way to the top.